Part 6, Off Spirituality of Saint John Paul II from the beginning of his life. Many of Poland's monarchs were devout Catholics. As a defender of the faith, one of Poland's greatest accomplishments was the defeat of the Ottoman Turks under the command of King Jan Sobieski III at the Battle of Vienna. Leaving Warsaw to command the troops of Europe, he first visited major Polish shrines along the way to request heaven's aid in a crucial mission that would either save Christian Europe or lose it to the Muslims. Upon achieving victory, he proclaimed, in a twist on Julius Caesar's famous statement, Veni, Vidi, Deus Visit. But that was probably the last of Poland's glory days because the country was already in a political, economic, and military decline. This was the nation into which Saint John Paul II was born, a nation whose history and culture formed a distinctive Polish mentality and Catholic spirituality. The city, which he called home for 40 years and which his heart never really left, was an integral element of that Polish history and culture, which would shape his personal spirituality. Krakow was the former seat of the Polish monarchy. It grew up on the bank of the Vistula River at the base of Wawel Hill, where Polish kings built their royal castle and cathedral. So important was Wawel in the minds of Poles that, even after the capital was moved to Warsaw in the 17th century, Wawel Cathedral remained the site of royal coronations and the final resting place of Polish kings. In his autobiographical work, Dari Tajemnica, Saint John Paul recalled what a great experience it was to attend the sacred Triduum in Wawel Cathedral once during his high school years, at the invitation of Father Kazimierz Figlwiz, one of the parish priests in Wadowice. So important was the royal sacral complex on Wawel Hill in the historical consciousness of Poles, that in the 19th century it was often referred to as the Polish Acropolis or Polish Zion. When Karol Wojtyla came to occupy the episcopal seat of the Archbishops of Krakow, he had a deep realization that he himself had then become a part of that sacred site. Krakow had always been a great center of culture in Poland. It was the place where Karol Wojtyla's own cultural talents and sensitivities matured. It was there that he learned that culture had always played a vital role in the faith, fully conscious that it had also played an important role in the shaping of his own spirituality. Because of its numerous churches, monasteries, shrines, and miraculous images, Krakow was often called the Rome of the North. Since the 10th century, it was already a prominent center of Christian pilgrimage. But the 15th century, in particular, was a unique and blessed period in the city's spiritual history. Known as Felix Siculum Krakowii, the happy century of Krakow, it was a period when a number of mystics, later canonized or beatified, lived there. Some of them played an influential role in the spirituality of Saint John Paul II. From among the saints of Krakow's Felix Siculum, the one to whom Saint John Paul had the greatest devotion was Saint John Cantius, patron of the Jagiellonian University, as well as of Krakow itself. Two characteristics of the saint's life stand out as something that particularly influenced Saint John Paul: cultivation of the intellect within the context of a life of holiness and an intense love for youth, especially students. Born in 1390, Saint John of Kiti, as he is also known, studied at the Jagiellonian University and then later spent the rest of his life there as a professor of philosophy and theology. Saint John Paul, therefore, saw in the saint a model of what he himself was, a philosopher and a theologian. Throughout his many years in Krakow, he visited the saint's tomb in the beautiful church of St. And many times and there drew much inspiration from his own patron saint of learning. It was no surprise, therefore, that during his 1997 pilgrimage to Poland, he made a point of visiting the tomb of St. John Cantius, where during a special gathering with professors of the Jagiellonian University, he alluded to the saint, saying, "Knowledge and wisdom seek a covenant with holiness." It was in St. John of Kiti that Saint John Paul saw clearly that Christian faith and the pursuit of human knowledge were not mutually exclusive, as many think today. It was the same thought that produced his famous encyclical, Fides et Ratio. That same perspective revealed itself especially in Saint John Paul's love for young people and students that he shared with the saint from Kiti, who once wrote, What kind of work can be more noble than to cultivate the minds of young people, guarding it carefully, so that the knowledge and love of God and His holy precepts go hand in hand with learning? To form young Christians and citizens, isn't this the most beautiful and noble-minded way to make use of life, of all one's talents and energy? Saint John Paul II had a particularly great devotion to his early predecessor as Archbishop of Krakow, the great St. Stanislaus Panowski, bishop and martyr. In fact, upon accepting the papacy, his first inclination was to choose the name Stanislaw. Thanks for watching. Please share and subscribe for more. Saint John Paul II, pray for the world.